When the 1970s rolled in, anyone who doubted the determination of the Gurindjis to hold out for their land must have been starting to think twice. And it was clear that if Labor wasn't going to change the situation, nothing would.
The Gurindji decided they wouldn't wait for any government to give them land, and they would never go back to work as a tribe at Wave Hill Cattle Station. If they weren't going to be given the land, they would take it. "We're going to take it back," they said. "We're not waiting for anybody. We will take back our land a little bit at a time."
Then Vincent Lingyari, he boarded an airplane, landed in Sydney, big city of lights. Daily he went round, softly speaking his story to all kinds of men from all walks of life.
Vincent sat down with epic politicians. This affair, they told him, it's a matter of state. Let us sort it out. Why are people hungry? Vincent said, no thanks, we know how to wait.
From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow.
Then Vincent Lingyari returned in an airplane back to his country, once more to sit down. He told his people, let the stars keep on turning. We have friends in the south, in the cities and towns.
"8 years went by, 8 long years of waiting, to one day a tall stranger appeared in the land. And he came with lawyers, came with great ceremony. Through Vincent's fingers, poured a handful of sand.
I solemnly hand to you these deeds as proof in Australian law that these lands belong to the Gurindji people."
That was the story of Vincent Lingyari. This is the story of something much more. A power and privilege cannot move a people who know where they stand, and they stand in their law. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow. From little things, big things grow.
There's a painting done by Peter Hudson. It's Vincent Lingyari, it's Frank Hardy at a typewriter, and it's me standing there with no shirt on and Paul Kelly. You know, the painting does depict the people that have told this story. And it's about a remarkable struggle led by a remarkable man.
After doing some research, reading Frank Hardy's book, I made my first trip to Gurindji country in 1998. It was a wonderful experience. It was the first time I'd been to this part of the Northern Territory. I found it exhilarating experience that the basic landscape is pretty much flat savanna type country with a lot of small hills dotting the landscape. I think they're called jump ups, the small hills. There's a lot of feral animals, brumbies and wild donkeys within the landscape that make it sort of pretty interesting. The people themselves were very, very generous. They're very proud people. They're very aware of their history. They allowed me to photograph them, paint them, and move about quite freely in their land, which I found an incredible privilege. So yes, all in all, it was a wonderful experience working in this country on my first trip and my subsequent three or four trips to Gurindji country. I was lucky enough to have the luxury of camping in on the community itself, so I had time to think about what I was going to do with the paintings. Normally I like to sit in front of a landscape for sometimes an hour or two, just to somehow dig a little bit behind the surface a wee bit, and try to extract some of the spiritual part of the land. And I find that from experience and painting landscapes for a while, this can happen for you. I mean, you can, the landscape somehow gives up some of its secrets, and you can sort of take the paintings maybe to a different level. And this is one of the beauties of landscape painting, and especially in a landscape as full of history and beauty as this one.
That was the story of Vincent Langari. This is the story of something much more. Our power and privilege cannot move a people.